domestic export, it is likely to improve the competitiveness, but not necessarily. So that you have to judge. Can increase the foreign value of domestic currency. Foreign value of domestic currency improves the trade balance. Trade balance, we cannot say much about the trade balance also. So in this way you have to deduce its answer. Improve the, so increases the foreign value of the domestic currency. Devaluation. So in this manner you can answer this question. Although, see, there are 4-5 questions are here in which you will be getting certain means certain intuition that this is right, this is wrong or right. So out of these 8 questions you can get 6 questions right, even if not all. I am saying that all are doable, they are not out of the box questions, but even then you may get 2 or 3 wrong, so there is no harm in it. So even if you attempt 6 or 5 correctly, then also it's good, okay. And you should not start analyzing the question at the time of exam itself. You should take the time when means you should have that patience that after doing all the questions or after doing the CSAT paper, I will analyze the questions. Similarly, this, the creation of black money in India has been the main cause of worry to the government of India. Which one of the following effects? So always we talk about this. This is also a general awareness question from the newspaper also or from the Vision magazine also. Then which one of the following is likely to be the most inflationary in its effects? Most inflationary, what options are there? Creation of new money to finance, repayment of public debt, borrowing from public to finance. So this creation of new money is always inflationary. So this debate was also there when we had recession, that the many of these opposition parties or many of the economists had suggested to the government that print more and more money to finance the this fiscal deficit or the needs of the people. So this debate was there. So if you had gone through the newspaper at that point of time, then you must have known these things. Then money multiplier, it is also a standard question from the from our this NCRT itself, macroeconomics NCRT. With reference to Indian economy, demand pull inflation can be caused by demand pull inflation. This you can answer from any of these books like Sanjeev Verma, Ramesh Singh or this Sriram, or even in this Vision IS magazine also. They have mentioned many of these things. So I think all these questions, 12 questions of economy were doable. Water credit. So if you know about water credit, then you can answer it, otherwise you can leave it in the first round, okay. You can later on read these statements in the second round, that if you can relate some concepts with some concepts within these 2-3 statements or with water credit, so whatever you decide, then you should mark it. Then center, so these all are this lender of last resort, it is also a standard question. It is also given in our NCRT. R2 code of practice, it was new to me, I did not read it anywhere, okay. So you can take up it in the third round, if you know it, then very well answer in first round, otherwise you can take up it in second or third round, wherever you are comfortable. Then coming to this, there a concern about copper smelting plants. So for this question also, we might not have that much sufficient knowledge, so we may not answer it in first round. Then furnace oil, it can be done through this elimination. It is a product of oil refineries. Some industry use it to generate power. Its use causes sulfur emissions into environment. So there was a debate also, or a news in our Vision IS only, that some furnace oil is being banned in India or furnace oil is being banned in other developed countries. So that was because of the sulfur emissions. So you can answer it accordingly. And blue carbon, everybody knows now. This fern, lichen, lichen moss and mushroom. So, to be found surviving on a surface without soil. On a surface without soil, like lichen and moss, they are there on water or some moist surface like rock where soil is not there. But fern, you must have seen it, it is on the ground, and also mushroom, that is, that grows during our rainy season. You must have seen it grows on the ground or soil. So that way you can, even if you do not know about the mushroom, then also you can answer it. Like fern is wrong, so one is wrong here, so two and three only, two only or two and three. Then you have to make a call.
So the questions you are leaving in the first reading, by the first reading, while you are marking the questions, can you also eliminate the statement simultaneously?
Yeah, yeah. Sure. During the first reading, when you read a particular question and you know that this statement is wrong, but I am not sure about other statement, then mark something on it, like cross or something, whatever you are comfortable with, so that in the second reading you do not waste time on that particular statement. So that is a good idea, and you should do that.
How much time during the first reading
it may take up to 1 hour 5 minutes or 1 hour 10 minutes.
Okay,
60 to 70 minutes. So Murnal notes on economy, yes, they are very very good. I missed that. Even if you do not want to do all these things, the standard books, Ramesh Singh and Sanjeev Verma or Sidharam, then Murnal notes are very very comprehensive, and you can do that. Okay. Then our natural mosquito repellent. In this question, you either you know it or you don't know. So lemongrass is the answer, but if you have not read it anywhere, then you cannot take risk in this question. Because any of these grass can be used in as a repellent, we do not know. So you can leave that question if you do not know anything about this. Kinds of organic copepods, cyanobacteria, diatoms, foraminifera, there are food chains of oceans. So I don't know this question. Okay. So if somebody knows it, then answer it, otherwise leave it. Then consider the following animals, hedgehog, marmot, pangolin, to reduce the chances of being captured by predators. Organize the roles of roll up and protect their vulnerable parts. Like hedgehog, everybody knows there is a little mouse on which there are thorns like structures, and it throws those thorns also. And pangolin, everybody knows its scales are no there, and which rises when it has to threaten its predator. So, and we do not know about the, I did not know about the marmot. So I will take up that 1, 2, 3 only. And I have one option, 1 and 3. So I know about, surely about 1 and 3. So 1 and 3 should be answered. If there had been an option of 1, 2, 3, then I might have been in confusion. So that is not the case here. So options, actually the options make the question difficult. Not the question itself is difficult. So you have to work on that also. Similarly, New York Declaration on Forests. So there are many statements given. Magnetite particles. So in such questions like magnetite particles suspected to cause neurodegenerative problems are generated as environmental pollutants from which of the following? So you can answer, means in such questions also you should be means biased toward answering all. I mean to say means all, in all of these processes, in this pollutant releases, because in a very very minute amount also you might find these pollutants in a particular process or a particular product. So you may not be sure about that, so it is better to go with the all. Okay, so it is one of the generic rule which I use during my prelims paper. Then,
how many tested you wrote in your prelims examination?
How many tests? I attempted around 50 tests in 50 or more than 50, around 55 tests in my first attempt for prelims. Okay, fine. So answer is oyster, but I did not know this answer also. So you can avoid it in your first reading. Then this biogeochemical cycles. It has come from NCRTs, directly from NCRTs, geography NCRT, or even in environment NCRT also, 12th NCRT. Then detriti wars, this you know, earthworm is detriti wars, 1-1-1, so B is eliminated. Then there is wood lice, you know that it is there in our hairs also, so wood lice there must be, it is on wood material, so 1 and 5 are there in C and D, but jellyfish does not seem to be, or sea horses also do not seem to be under this detriti horse category. So I might have marked it as C. C as correct option 1, 3, and 5. So that way you can deduce the right answer. You have to take chances actually. If you will answer these 4-5 questions, then you might get 3 questions correct, and that is in our favor, because 2 questions, if you are getting wrong, then there is no harm. If at the cost of that, you are getting 3 questions right. Carbon, common carbon metric, it is there in Vision IS magazine. Then, cnidarians, fungi and protozoa, symbiotic relationship. So, fungi always makes symbiotic relationship, and protozoa also makes symbiotic relationship. Now left is the cnidarians. So in that question you have to take a call that whether to mark it as 1, 2, 3 or 2 and 3. So in such questions where you do not have that much knowledge, or you think that you are lacking in knowledge, then you can take an inclusive approach. Inclusive approach I mean to say is you should include 1. Means you are sure about 2 and 3, but you are not sure about this 1. And you are confused between 2 and 3 and 1, 2 and 3, then you should mark 1, 2 and 3. Means this is the inclusive approach which I call. Okay, so I have told you 2 things. One is the mark all wherever there is a question like whether it is released from this process or not. Or in such questions where you have confusion in 2 and 3 and 1, 2 and 3. And you have no idea about this one. If you know, then it's fine. You can answer, but I am telling from my own perspective, because I am not aware about this cnidarian thing. So I would have marked this 1, 2 and 3. Okay.
So you would have attempted this question in your first reading only?
No, I would not have attempted it in my first reading, because I am not sure about this. I would have attempted this question, 27th question, in my first reading, because I am sure about this. I would have attempted this carbon metric in my first reading, okay, but I would not have marked these 2 questions, because they might take certain time, and in the first reading I may not emphasize on many things. So you should mark it as mark for review, and then review it again in your second round. Then coming to this Chaushat Yogini temple near Morena, so in this you must focus on this thing. It is the only circular temple built in India. There are many circular temples are in India. Even there is one temple in my village which is circular. So how can they say that it is the only circular temple built in India? So on this fact only, on the basis of this fact only, you can also answer this question. Like 2 is wrong. So 2 is there in all the options except C. So 2 is wrong, A, B, D are wrong, and C is the right answer. You do not have to read all the options, all the statements. But you can read it. Means its design has given rise to a popular belief that it was an inspiration behind the Indian Parliament building. Right? And then the Dholavira. This Dholavira was in news because of UNESCO. UNESCO has declared it as World Heritage Site, and in the Vision IS magazine, it was very well explained that the water structures were there. And in the first quarter of 17th century, Broach, means which factories were set up by East India Company. So Broach, it is Bharuch, we knew that during they are talking about the first quarter of the 17th century, so from 1600 to 1625. So I can recall one fact that the Hector Munro went to the court of Jahangir. Jahangir had allowed to set up a factory at Surat and Broach, I can recall it. So Broach is the answer. Broach is correct. But Trichinopoli, it was not set up during the first quarter, because they were set up later when these Madras and Calcutta were also came under the British or the East India Company's supremacy. Okay. So you have to now C and D are eliminated. Now you are confused between one only and 1 and 2. So I would again use the inclusive approach. That means I would use 1 and 2. I would answer 1 and 2, not 1 only. Because I am not sure about Chikapur. Okay. So that may be wrong or that may be right, I do not know. But that way you have to answer the questions. I would answer it in the second reading, okay, not in the first one. In the Harshvardhana, I have not read this question. Let us leave this. Then this Nunes, Portuguese writer Nunes, the woman in Vijayanagar Empire were expert in which of the following areas? So in such question, because we have not read the book of Nunes for his text, his work, so in such question, if there is an option of 1, 2, 3 and 4, then I would go with 1, 2 and 3 and 4. But at the same time, I would also apply the common sense, like astrology, wrestling, accounting and soothsaying. So they are talking about the astrology also, wrestling, soothsaying. I do not know what this soothsaying is. It means Bhavishyavani, okay. So this question I will mark, because I have certain knowledge or certain basis on which I can mark. Means woman did not participate in the wrestling that much, also in astrology, because it was a field of supremacy of Brahmins, so they may not have allowed woman to do these things. So on this basis I would deduce certain thing and I will mark it. I am not sure about what is the answer of it. Okay. Then Madan Palle of Andhra Pradesh. Yes, please.
That particular question you would have reserved for third round, right?
Yeah, definitely. Okay. I will mark this question only when I will feel that I am not I have not attempted the adequate questions, like I am at 70 or 72, or if I would be above 85, then I will not answer this question. Okay.
Correct, sir.
Yeah. Madan Palle of Andhra Pradesh. I do not know its answer. If somebody has read it, they can answer. Otherwise, I don't know.
Sir, but you said that you preferably attempt more than 95, then how to differentiate which question to leave and which not to leave? That's where we falter.
Yeah, so I told you, there was one question of oyster. Oyster, and before that also there was one question which I said I would not attempt this question. This one, congress grass, elephant grass, lemon grass, nut grass. I do not have an iota of idea about this. Then how would I answer this question? So I will leave this question. Okay. Because there, out of all, even if I am able to eliminate one option, then also, or two options, then I will attempt that question. But I am not able to eliminate even a single question here, single option here. So I will not mark it. Okay, so that call you have to make at the time of exam, and you will develop this thing while you will attempt the mocks. Now coming to question. Okay. Madan Palle, if you know, then you can answer. not sure. If somebody from Andhra Pradesh or that region, they can answer it very well. Then coming to this historical place and well known for, this is there in the NCRT, you can answer it properly. This is the Indus River feed of fugitive for them brains. I don't know whether it is there in the...
Excuse me, sir.
Yes, please.
सर फॉर एग्जाम्पल वो जो मदन पल्ले वाला क्वेश्चन था, अगर मतलब उस उन चारों स्टेटमेंट्स में से अगर मैं एक भी में श्योर कि ये पक्का नहीं है, लाइक वन ऑफ देम इज फॉर श्योर रॉन्ग, जो टोटल नंबर ऑफ क्वेश्चन है वो कम हो रहे हैं 80s में ज्यादा, तो आई शुड गो फॉर द अदर क्वेश्चन.
बिल्कुल बिल्कुल, यू शुड गो विद, यू शुड मार्क दैट क्वेश्चन. What will happen now? I am saying this because if in suppose in first 20 questions you are not able to mark more than 4 or 5, then you will be underconfident, and this thing will impact your rest of the questions also, or the rest of the paper. If you are able to mark even 10 questions out of 20, then you will get confidence that I am marking 10 questions. Even if you are marking them wrong, but you do not know them at the point of exam, but it will give you a confidence that I am marking it, and the rest of paper I will in the rest of the paper also I will be able to mark. So you will be confident, and you will have positive energy, and you will attempt that paper in a very positive manner. Okay, so this is also a game of psychology. So that thing you have to.
Excuse me, sir.
Yes.
Sir, initially you were talking about identifying the right answer. So generally क्या हो रहा है कि जब option mark कर रहा हूँ तो दो सही, दो option जो eliminate करने हैं वो कर लेता हूँ. लेकिन बाकी जो दो बच जाते हैं उसमें सर गलत वाला mark. तो इसका कोई तरीका है सर mark?
इसका तरीका कुछ नहीं है. ये आप ऐसा रहेगा कि जैसे suppose करो 20 question है ऐसे आपके पास, या 10 question है. 10 में से 5 आपके सही होंगे, 5 गलत होंगे, क्योंकि 50-50 प्रोबेबिलिटी है. तो 5 सही हुए तो 5 के आपको कितना मिलेगा, 10 मार्क, और जो नेगेटिव हुए 5 का उसका कितना कटेगा, 5 उसका कट जाएगा, मतलब ऑलमोस्ट 2 क्वेश्चंस चले जाएंगे. तो 5 में से 2 गए तो 3 आपके करेक्ट हुए ना, टोटल 6 मार्क्स आपने गेन किया आउट ऑफ दोज 10 क्वेश्चन. सो ओवरऑल यू विल बी इन बेनिफिट.
सर मेरे में करेक्ट रॉन्ग में 50-50 का नहीं हो रहा प्रोपोर्शन, सर मेरा नेगेटिव ज्यादा हो रहा है.
ओके, सो इन दैट केस आई वुड सजेस्ट यू टू मींस आइदर रिवाइज योर सिलेबस, और इफ यू थिंक दैट रिवाइज योर कंटेंट, और इफ यू थिंक दैट यू हैव रिवाइज योर कंटेंट मींस सैटिस्फैक्टरीली और मोर देन एनफ, देन यू हैव टू broaden your content, because if you are not getting many questions out of the paper, then it means you are lacking knowledge. Okay, so you should widen your sources or widen your content, because it may happen that you are reading a very little thing about a particular event or particular episode. So you have to read that in depth if this is happening with you.
Okay, sir.
Yes.
Sir, a continuation question for that, sir. Sir, actually, can I ask you, sir?
Yeah, please.
Sir, actually, the initial, after 2 to 3 months of preparation, let's say you have read some Lakshmikant or some economy, initially we start with that. But when we saw some any topic, usually we don't understand anything in the newspaper. Like, because, for example, when we read some editorial or some new news, It is running from 10 to 15 years or more than that, but we don't have any clue about it. Suddenly there is an editorial. So at that time we should have to gather some information, like you are saying that we have to widen your market, etc. So we have to go and gather information from the newspaper, or else you just leave it and later on from the coming months you will automatically get the knowledge of it. How should we gain?
There is only one article or two article in one newspaper, two newspaper, then you can leave it. Okay, just read the article. But, or otherwise, if there are articles on regular basis, means the issue is very old, but the articles are there for around for 4 or 5 days, then you must know that that thing from at that point itself. You should not leave it to the your current affair magazine. Okay, you are getting my point. Means if there is only one or two article, then it means it is a random information. You should not bother about that much. Okay, but if they are recurring again and again for 4 or 5 days, or they are in other newspapers also, or even after 5-10 days, then you must know that issue in detail.
Sir, I heard someone from I have a senior once. So once he said he returned, we went to one interview. So sorry for bringing his perspective. I just want to have a confirmation. Sir, actually, what he kindly said is that earlier he said for 1 year, sir, that once you get any article on it, you dig little bit on it and gather some information and write it on your notes. So after 3 to 4 months, if the again that related article came also, like after few months, then you have already information and your research didn't got waste. So that at that time you don't have to again research on it. So I thought it's a long shot, but that's why I just want to have your opinion on it, like whether it will be time waste to go dig on it, or like what you have said is correct.
Time waste, complete time waste, but the cost benefit ratio is not that much. Okay, you will
yes.
Get lot of input, but you will not get that much output. So that is the thing only. Nothing goes waste, yeah. Nothing goes waste completely. Okay, so that
yes,
that's
sir.
My opinion.
Sorry sir, bringing someone's perspective, I just want to confirm.
No problem, we are here to discuss these things now.
Thanks.
Okay. So now the next question is, St. Francis was one of the founding members of the Jesuit order. So these things either you know or you don't know, because these are the facts. Okay. And I have somewhere read that St. Francis Xavier brought this Christian religion to India. So you can relate that those things and identify certain questions. Because I am not an expert on this particular subject, so I should not comment on it. But Mithaksharantaya Bhaga, again this has come from the current affairs. Then I had told you about this 1919 Act, 1909 Act, 1935 Act. So they every time ask this. And then you can prepare them. And this 8th August 1942, everybody knows this from, this is there in every book of modern history. Songs from prison. So in this question, you can eliminate like this, like a translation of ancient Indian religious lyrics in English. So it is a translation of religious lyrics. So Jawaharlal Nehru is not that much inclined towards religion. Again, Sarojini Naidu is also not that much inclined towards religion. Now we are left with Tilak and Gandhi. So out of these two, I do not find any difference that how should I mark them. Like songs from prison. So Tilak can also write, and because he had also went for jail many times, and Gandhiji also went in jail for many times. So out of these, Tilak and Gandhi, you have to mark one. That call you have to make. Okay. And then this thing, medieval India, that. It is given in means every book of medieval India. It is actually the Mughal administration hierarchy. Then the secretary of Bethune School, so Ishwar Chandra Vidya Sagar. This is there in every modern India book in the chapter of reform, social reforms. Then Shah Nawaz Khan, Prem Kumar Sehgal. This is given in Spectrum. I don't know about other books. Then Ajanta Caves, Vagora, I do not know much about this also. Like we can eliminate in this, like Sanchi Ustupa lies in the gorge of Chambal River. Chambal does not flow that much in this Madhya Pradesh. And Pandulena Caves, Shrines, Amravati Ustupa is there on Godavari, so I think D should be the answer. So in this manner you have to deduce that Chambal River, that Sanchi is in Madhya Pradesh, that we know for sure. But Chambal flows very little in Madhya Pradesh. And Sanchi is near, I think, near Bhopal. What Chambal rises from not from Bhopal but little northwards in Madhya Pradesh. So you can eliminate options like that. 21st February is declared to be International Mother Tongue Day by UNICEF. So International Mother Tongue Mother Language Day, this is more related with the culture. Okay, so culture means UNESCO, not the UNICEF. If something is related with the children like child labor or child malnutrition, then that can be by UNICEF. But International Mother Tongue Day, Mother Language Day, it should be by UNESCO. So that is the only idea. And second, the demand that Bangla has to be one of the national languages was raised in the Constituent Assembly of Pakistan. So this is a very well known fact. When we read about the Pakistan, this Bangladesh Liberation War, then this fact comes there. Permaculture, then palm oil. Palm oil tree is native to Southeast Asia. From this you can answer the question. Like British had brought the palm oil into India and also to the Southeast Asia, means Europeans, not British. So this way you can answer. So if you eliminate one, then 2 and 3 should be the answer, even if you are not reading other statements. Indus Direct, 3 of them, 4 into 1 of them, which joins the Indus Direct among the following? So these questions, sometimes they seem random and you can attempt them, whatever you feel, means you might, when you have prepared this Indus River, you might have remembered its tributaries and their order, means from north to south and south to north and again north to south, because 3 are given to this Pakistan and 3 to India. So all these things means you can relate any of such facts with this, but you cannot get the exact answer. So that way you have to attempt these questions. Okay, and then Didwana, Kuchaman, Sargol, Khatu are the names of, like Didwana. Didwana is given as a Paleolithic site, also Paleolithic or Mesolithic site in history. So you must recall from there that Didwana is in Rajasthan. So no glaciers are there in Rajasthan. Mangroves areas are also not there. You know about the Ramsar sites of Rajasthan or even of whole India. And the option left is Saline Lakes. Consider the following rivers. So in this manner you have to answer that question. Now I think you must be getting that thing that the question, the paper was not that much difficult. Do you agree with me or not? Because most of the questions were from the our basic sources, and the questions which were random for everyone. If you have prepared well from all these sources, basic sources, then you are at par with the other peers. So you will not be at a loss in comparison to other peers. Okay, so do you agree with me or not that whether 2021 was a difficult paper or not? Please second my opinion. You can...
Hello?
Yeah.
Hello, sir. How to crack in first item UPSC itself, sir. Give some tips.
You are writing means?
No, sir. I am still preparing. I am giving my first attempt in next year.
Okay. Next year means 2022.
Yes, sir.
Okay, good. So, means actually, first of all, you should not be in a hurry to attempt the questions. To take your attempt. Okay. Means if you have prepared well for the prelims in your first 6 or 7 months or 10 months, then you should also be very well prepared for the mains while writing the prelims, because you cannot be sure when you will clear the prelims that you will be able to write the mains in a very very efficient or effective manner to get a good rank. Therefore you must, I would suggest to at least give 12 to 15 months to whole preparation, means 10 months for prelims and then 5 months for mains, and then write this exam, or write the prelims exam, then clear it, then mains, because you already have prepared for mains properly, so you will not face such problem in mains again. so you will clear mains, and interview you can prepare after mains. That is no harm in that. So that way you can assure your selection in the first attempt. So means 12 to 15 months study is required, or maybe
sir
18 months.
Sir,
yes
sir, if after eliminating two options I go for wrong option, is it luck or lack of hard work?
No, it is not a lack of hard work, it is just a matter of choice. Means at that point what choice you made. Okay, so there is no
sir how to improve that choice?
Yeah, we cannot do actually. We cannot do much about it.
Sir, because I missed the scripts, I think about 5 or 6 months. And I marked many questions wrong, in which I had eliminated 2 options.
Okay. Yeah, actually I do not have any idea on that. Actually, I do not have any solution for that. One thing you can do, if you are getting this thing in many questions or in major questions, majority of questions, like out of 10 you are getting 8 wrong in such circumstances, then it is better to leave that question, because it will eventually cost you. Okay, so that call you have to make. I do not have any solution for that. I am sorry.
Sir, if you would excuse me, discuss some other questions from the paper, because they seem to be quite tough, but not from the regular sources. Sir, IR
questions. Okay, IR questions I will take up.
Sir, what is the reason why you have mentioned Subhash Kashyap power constitution, sir? Generally it is not popular, so it's typical Lakshmi Kant. So may I know the reason, sir?
Subhash Kashyap was, or I think he is still alive, he is a constitutional lawyer. So he knows many things about the constitution and their philosophy. Means Lakshmi Kant largely focuses upon the factual part of the constitution, whereas it lacks in the philosophical part of the constitution. So for getting that to understand that philosophical part of constitution, this Subhash Kashyap book helps. So therefore I am recommending it.
So we should read it in between prelims, NCERT and Lakshmi Kant, or after Lakshmi Kant?
After Lakshmi Kant, read it after Lakshmi Kant.
And one more thing, sir, did you make any prelims wise notes of the standard book, sir?
I have made certain notes, like wherever there are, means many points are given, like I can recall, then I had made notes of these things, these all acts, 1813 acts, and compared them in a tabular form, so that I could analyze that at what stage, what steps, what new provisions were there. Similarly, what were the imports during 18th century in India, or what were the exports? So all these things I had made notes of, but I did not do much notes making for prelims. And other things which are randomly asked, like Ramsar sites or other dance forms, for them also I had made notes in a single place.
Sir, I find Shankar book very vague, sir. Shankar's book. Did you find it like that, sir, or do you find it very interesting?
It is not vague. Some of its part are vague, like they have not explained these things, means policies, rules and laws, in very much detail. But whatever they have mentioned, it is sufficient, and you can also go through the bare acts of those all the policies or acts. So you can supplement the Shankar IS book. I do not find it much vague.
Thanks, sir. One last thing. Have you made newspaper that one page or notes? Or did you make it, sir? Or you just read the monthly magazine and the newspaper for the perspective only, for the prelims?
For the prelims?
Yes,
majorly I made notes of, I did not made notes of the newspaper, but if there is certain factual information, like a new species found, like a butterfly is found in Andaman and Nicobar Island, then I would mention its name in my notes. Otherwise, I will not go through the whole articles and mentioning them in my notes. I would rely upon the the current affair magazines and the current affair compilations of PT365 and MES365.
Science and technology environment, those current super current affair related topics you have made notes of.
Yeah, but I did not make notes in detail. I am saying it. I made notes of only the factual information, not of the conceptual information.
Yes, sir. I got it. Yeah. Thank you for patiently answering. Thank you.
Sir,
one more question. Sir, for which subjects and from where will you suggest us to read Bayard's from?
The answer
sometimes for politics, sometimes for environment, sometimes for economy, sir. For how many subjects should we like go?
Not for all subjects, means for environment, there are 4, 5 acts or 10 acts which are there. You have to go through Bayard's acts. And for rest of the subjects, except from environment, you have to go through the particular sections of the act. Like depending on the news, like there is a news regarding section 66A of the IT Act, then you should know that what is 66A. You should go through the bare provision in that act. Or if somebody is saying about section 57 of the RBI Act, then you should know what is the section 67 of the RBI Act. You should read it from the original source. So that way you have to do in other subjects, and for environment you have to do certain acts in complete detail. Okay.
Sir, if you would excuse me, sir.
Yes, please.
So second or third round जो है prelims का मतलब exam करते time क्या उस पर थोड़ा detailed discussion कर सकते हैं like कितना time note करना चाहिए मतलब second and third round question को कैसे differentiate करना है. Yes sir, and in continuation of that also आपकी जो range रही होगी आपने decide की होगी box के दौरान कि मेरा I have to take more than 95 or in between 90 to 95, does that vary according to the difficulty level of the paper?
Yes, definitely. It varies with the difficulty level of paper also. So anything above 90, if you are satisfied, then it's good. But if you are attempting less than 80, then means in most of the paper, if it is very very difficult, it is completely difficult, then I cannot say. But generically, if you are attempting less than 80 or less than 75, then you should increase your attempt up to 85. That is my say on that. And the previous question which was asked, that second and third round, in the first round should finish by मतलब वो खत्म हो जाना चाहिए एक घंटा मतलब 60 से 70 मिनट के बीच, फिर आप OMR फिल कर लीजिए 10-15 मिनट्स में, मतलब वो हो जाएंगे आपके 1 hour 25 minutes एटलीस्ट. फिर जो सेकेंड राउंड होगा उसमें आप एटलीस्ट 25 मिनट्स दीजिए, और उसमें साथ ही साथ आप OMR भी फिल करते रहिए बबल, जैसे एक क्वेश्चन आपने मार्क किया तो उसका OMR कर दिए साथ साथ. फिर जो थर्ड राउंड होगा उसमें भी सिमिलरली थोड़ा और टाइम देकर या थोड़ा गैस वर्क करके और साथ ही साथ OMR भरिए, तो ये रहेगा फर्स्ट सेकेंड एंड थर्ड राउंड.
सर सेकंड राउंड एंड थर्ड राउंड के क्वेश्चन में मतलब डिफरेंशिएट कैसे करें, क्योंकि दोनों में
गैस रहेगा कि आप दो में से दो स्टेटमेंट तीन स्टेटमेंट दिए हैं तो दो आपको आ रहे हैं या एक आ रहा है. थर्ड में कम्प्लीटली ऐसी चीज़ें रहेंगी जो जिसमें आपको मतलब बहुत ही कम आइडिया, मतलब वो आपको करने से आएगा. मैं नहीं समझा सकता उस चीज़ को, जब आप मॉक टेस्ट अटेम्प्ट करेंगे तो वो आएगा.
Yes.
Okay. So I will take up few questions from chat box. Yes, Yogesh, go ahead.
Sir, first of all, thank you for taking this session.
Yeah.
I wanted to know like your timeline, like when you graduated, and as I saw in one interview that you were selected as an assistant section officer.
Yeah.
In January. So like, can you just tell us about your timeline, like when did you started preparing full fledged for UPSC?
See, yeah, I had graduated in the year 2015. Then I did a private job with a private company till 2017 July. And I quit in 2017 July, and I had joined the coaching classes in August 2017. And from there only I had started my preparation. And from before August 2017, I did not do anything for UPSC preparation. Okay, anything, zero. I started from scratch. And then I gave this 2018 prelims, cleared it, and then gave mains. but could not clear mains. Then 2019 I cleared prelims mains but could not clear interview, and now I have cleared all the three stages. So this is brief timeline. So sir, from where these questions come, sir? Economy best source, you can go for Murnal plus NCRT, that is sufficient. For beginners, Murnal. But the answer is, okay, see, sir, right answer. Sir, please, aap ek baar bata dijiye, aap kitne round mein, okay. I have already told you that I attempted in 3 rounds. See, sir, mere negative bahut ho jate hain, like, maine 90 attempt kar diye, 40 galat ho gaye, please bataye negatives ko kam karne ke liye. If you are attempting 90 and you are getting 40 questions wrong, that means 50, 10, 13, that means you are lacking knowledge somewhere. I will be little brutal because you should know your weaknesses. So I would suggest you to either revise more or you should broaden your sources. Means whatever sources you have already done, do it completely, and then you can ask somebody or senior, or even you go through my book list, and you should diversify your sources, broaden your sources. Then you will get lesser marks and lesser questions incorrect. Sir, what is your revision strategy? How daily basis? I would revise book these things on, not on the daily basis, but I would revise on the basis of my test series. Okay, so during my first attempt, I would revise those things which were in the upcoming tests, and in the end I would revise again the whole of the syllabus. Means for the last 3 months I revised the full syllabus after doing the syllabus for 1 or 2 times before that. The strategy for crossing.
Excuse me, sir.
Yes.
Sir, can I ask the question? It will be difficult to take this long.
Yeah, please ask. I will take up this session only up to, means for 2 hours only. 1 hour 51 minutes has already happened now. Please ask.
Yes, sir. Thank you. Sir, actually, जो current affairs magazines होती है, मतलब मैंने जैसे vision की prefer की है, जो mains वाली है, उसमें से pre-com material निकल जाता है. तो बात रहती नोट्स की प्री तो वहीं से पढ़ सकते हैं बार बार जाके, बट मेंस का जैसे टॉपिक है कोई भी, मतलब फॉर एग्जांपल आईआर का कोई पोर्शन है, फिर कोई भी पॉलिटी में चल रहा है, तो और वो कोई चीज़ हम स्टैटिक में भी पढ़ रहे हैं, तो उसका इंटीग्रेशन कैसे करें हमें? शुड आई रिपीट?
या प्लीज रिपीट.
विजन की जो मैगजीन है प्री का, तो वहीं से हम वापस रीड कर सकते हैं, अगर जून की है, जुलाई की है, वी कैन गो मंथ वाइज. बट फॉर एग्जांपल पॉलिटी का टॉपिक है बैकवर्ड क्लासेस का, भी कास्ट सेंसस से रिलेटेड कोई भी टॉपिक आ रखा है करंट अफेयर्स में, एंड इट विल बी लाइक 2 से 3 मंथ्स में रिपीटेड होगा वो सेम टॉपिक, एंड वही हमें स्टैटिक पोर्शन में पढ़ना है, तो उसका इंटीग्रेशन मतलब कैसे हो पाएगा?
विजन की मैगजीन आती है उसमें वो बैकग्राउंड भी तो उसका देता है, किसी इशू का, इश्यू का, जैसे कास्ट सेंसस हो रही है तो कब फर्स्ट टाइम हुई थी, कब बंद हुई थी, क्या उसके रैशनल थे, तो सारा बैकग्राउंड भी तो देता है विजन वाला. तो प्रीलिम्स के लिए भी इंफॉर्मेशन देता है और मेंस के लिए भी जो मंथली में.
यस, सो आई मीन टू आस्क, कि आप मेंस के लिए मतलब वहीं से वो चीज रिपीट करते या फिर नोट्स बना लेते
हैं? नहीं, मैं नोट्स इन चीजों के करंट के मैंने कोई नोट्स नहीं बनाए हैं, बहुत कम नोट्स बनाए हैं करंट के. मैंने स्टैटिक के नोट्स बनाए क्योंकि वो कहीं मिलते नहीं है इतना, तो जो करंट वाला है वो मैं मंथली से पढ़ लूंगा, फिर मैं पढ़ लूंगा इसको उसमें से मेंस 365 में से, तो मेरा हो जाएगा. मैंने उसके लिए कोई नोट्स नहीं बनाए.
लेट्स सर, आपने बोला था कि आपके 2 साल पहले के करंट अफेयर्स भी कवर करने चाहिए हमें, तो मतलब मंथली मैगजीन्स उठाएं या कैसे करना चाहिए हमें?
मंथली मत उठाओ, आप वो कर लो, क्या कहते हैं, जो पीटी आया हुआ होगा ना लास्ट इयर्स का, वो कर लो, वो सफिशिएंट है. पीटी 365
सर, आपने फिर वो मंथली करंट अफेयर मैगजीन कितनी बार रिवाइज की थी, उनको भी बार बार रिवाइज किया?
एक्चुअली मेरा क्या था ना, जैसे फर्स्ट अटेम्प्ट में जब मेरा था तो मैंने उसके नोट्स बना लिए थे, नोट्स इन द सेंस की फैक्चुअल बेसिस पर, जैसे मैंने नोट्स अपना उस पर भी डाले थे शायद चैनल पे, तो उस उसमें मैंने नोट्स बना लिए थे कि जो फैक्चुअल थे, जैसे कि पूरा विजन का मैगजीन होता है उसमें से मेरे को 70 या 80 फैक्चुअल इन्फॉर्मेशन मिली, तो मैंने उसको 4 या 5 पेज में लिख के रख लिया हमेशा के लिए, और वो एक कॉपी में, और अगली बार अगले महीने का अगले उसी कॉपी में लिखता गया। ऐसे करके मेरे पास 3-4 कॉपियाँ हैं, तो उसमें मेरा 2017 से लेकर अब तक के मेरे पास नोट्स हैं, मतलब प्रीलिम्स के, वो सिर्फ 4 कॉपीज में, और उसमें सारी फैक्चुअल इन्फॉर्मेशन है, तो मैं उन कॉपीज को ही रिवाइज करता था रादर देन गोइंग बैक टू द मेन मंथली मैगजीन। तो ये चीज़ आप भी कर सकते हैं फैक्चुअल बेसिस पर, फैक्चुअल इन्फॉर्मेशन बस लिखनी है सारी।
और सर मतलब मेंस के अंदर आप स्टैटिक और करंट अलग अलग रिवाइज करते हैं?
स्टैटिक और करंट नहीं अलग अलग नहीं करता था। जैसे मेंस में क्या होता है ना, पर्टिकुलर टॉपिक होता है, जैसे इंडस्ट्रियल ग्रोथ, इंडस्ट्रियल ग्रोथ के लिए मैं स्टैटिक के अपने क्वेश्चंस, अपना जो नोट्स है वो देख लूंगा कि इंडस्ट्रियल रिवॉल्यूशन कैसे हुआ है, कौन कौन सी पॉलिसीज आई है इंडिया में, फिर उसके बाद जो इंडस्ट्री वाला ये इसमें चैप्टर दे रखा होता है इसमें मेंस 365 में, मैं उसको गो थ्रू कर लेता था, तो वो पूरा एक इंटीग्रेटेड मैनर में पूरा कवर हो जाता था कि पास से लेकर के अभी तक क्या इंसिडेंसेज या क्या इंफॉर्मेशन है, तो ये होता था।
सर
आप मेंस
365
में 2-3 साल के लिए किए थे? नहीं मेंस नहीं, मेंस मैंने एक्चुअली क्या हुआ ना, मैंने जैसे फर्स्ट अटेम्प्ट में दिया था, तो फर्स्ट अटेम्प्ट में तो मैंने एक ही साल का किया था, मतलब उसी साल का, जैसे सेकंड अटेम्प्ट में दिया तो मेरे पास फर्स्ट अटेम्प्ट का जो मेंस 365 था वो मैंने रिवाइज तो नहीं किया था, लेकिन वो कहीं ना कहीं मेरे बैक ऑफ द माइंड था, तो वो चीज़ हेल्प करती है। तो मैं आपको सजेस्ट करूँगा कि यदि आपके पास टाइम है तो यू कैन गो थ्रू दी मेंस 365 ऑफ पास्ट ईयर एज वेल इफ यू आर अटेम्प्टिंग फॉर द फर्स्ट टाइम, सो दैट डेफिनेटली हेल्प। नहीं उसमें बस हाईलाइट करो आप, उसमें नोट्स बनाओगे बहुत बल्की हो जाए, क्योंकि ऑलरेडी जो उसमें हाईलाइटेड या बोल्ड टेक्स्ट में दिया हुआ है उसको आप हाईलाइटर से हाईलाइट कर दो और सिर्फ वो न्यूज़ ही पढ़ो, वो न्यूज़ या वो चीज वो एलिमेंट ही पढ़ो, तो कुछ जाएगा, इतना बड़ा इशू नहीं आएगा। तो मैं अभी Please tell us clearly where did you थोड़ी देर में फोन करूंगा, कार्यक्रम में नहीं है, वो सेशन ले रहा हूँ जो बच्चा तैयारी कर रहे हैं। हाँ यस आकांक्षा गो अहेड।
आज पटिक के जो नोट्स बनाते थे वो क्या प्री और मेंस के अलग अलग बनाते थे या उसको इंटीग्रेट करते थे?
मंथली मैगजीन के
क्या होता है ना
तो जब आप उसको गो थ्रू करते हैं 2-3 बार तो ऑलरेडी आपको रिवाइज हो जाता है, क्योंकि एक चीज़ को 3 बार पढ़ोगे तो वो दिमाग में आ जाता है, आपको उतना उसका नोट्स बना के रिवाइज करने की ज़रूरत नहीं होती है। लेकिन जब स्टैटिक पोर्शन जब ये होता है, मतलब जो करंट होता है वो तो इवॉल्व होता रहता है, तो वो आपको रिवाइज करना पड़ता है फ्रिक्वेंटली मेंस के लिए। और मेंस का तरीका भी अलग है ना, मेंस में आपको इन्फॉर्मेशन खुद लिखनी है, जबकि प्रीलिम्स में इन्फॉर्मेशन ऑलरेडी है, यू जस्ट हैव टू लिंक दोज इन्फॉर्मेशन फ्रॉम द विद द क्वेश्चन दैट इज बीइंग आस्क्ड। उतना डिफिकल्ट नहीं होता प्रीलिम्स में जितना कि मेंस में रिकॉल करना डिफिकल्ट होता है, इसलिए मेंस के नोट्स बनाए जाते हैं। ठीक है
सर, आपने इकोनॉमिक्स इकोनॉमिक्स सर्वे भी 2-3 साल का पढ़ा था?
इकोनॉमिक्स सर्वे नहीं, 2-3 साल का नहीं पढ़ा मैंने, इनिशियली 1 ईयर का पढ़ा था। फिर मैं एक्चुअली मेरे को पता लग गया था कि उसमें से क्या काम का होता है क्या नहीं, फिर मैंने सेलेक्टिवली पढ़ा था कुछ कुछ चैप्टर्स। तो मतलब फर्स्ट अटेम्प्ट में मैंने 1 ही साल का पढ़ा था। ठीक है, तो प्लीज टेल अस क्लियरली वेयर यू डिड मिस्टेक्स इन प्रीलिम्स और मेंस, इलैबोरेटली पॉसिबल राइट आर्टिकल ऑन दिस। ओके आई विल शेयर दिस। सो आई नोट योर सजेशन लाइक इन able to answer these questions. You will read these in your content. So it is not a big deal. The newspaper से main perspective से notes बनाए या फिर vision को, सिर्फ vision को follow करो, newspaper को अच्छे से पढ़ो, उसको understand करो और that is all. You do not have to make the notes out of the newspaper or mains. Sir, really grateful for simplicity which you do. What helped the most during prelims exam, statistics or QIQ or elimination during prelims exam? एक्चुअली सारा ये जो कॉम्बिनेशन है, ये महेश आप जो पूछ रहे हैं, इसमें जो सारा कॉम्बिनेशन है, दिस ऑल थिंग्स इन कॉम्बिनेशन हेल्प मी। सो बट स्टैटिक एंड स्टैटिक जो कंटेंट है दैट ऑलवेज हेल्प्स, दैट ऑलवेज हेल्प्स यू। सो
यस सर,
आई वुड से द स्टैटिक थिंग हेल्प द मोस्ट। ओके सर, जैसा कि आपने मुझे कहा कि आपको नेगेटिव स्ट्रोक करने सोर्सेज को अवॉइड करना चाहिए, अवॉइड सोर्स क्या होने चाहिए? Not from the coachings, but whatever I have mentioned in the this book list, you just do that. Please take up IR questions, so I do not have time. This is details I told you earlier. No. If you are first attempt, this is okay. So I will take up one or two questions from strategy for crossing forest cutoff. I will take up separately because there is no such strategy. It will evolve over a period of time. No particular strategy that you will clear forest with this strategy. But there are few things which you have to do that I can tell in Telegram channel. Okay, and I will take up one or two of this IR question as being.
Sir, I have a question.
Sorry.
Sir, I have a question.
Yes, please ask the last question.
सर, जो आपने जैसे ड्यूरेशन के आइटरेशन बताया कि हम 3-4 बार रिवाइज किया था प्रीलिम्स में, तो ये जो आपके आइटरेशन थे ये मॉक्स के साथ चल रहे थे साइमल्टेनियसली, इन फर्स्ट यूज टू रिवाइज देन यू यूज टू टेल द मॉक्स?
सी व्हाट आई वुड डू वाज, फर्स्ट ऑफ ऑल आई वुड रीड ऑल द थिंग्स व्हिच आर बीइंग टॉट इन माय क्लासेस, और इफ नॉट इन क्लासेस देन आई वुड रीड इट ऑन माय ओन, व्हाटएवर इज गिवन इन दिस सिलेबस और इन बुक। Then that was my first reading. Then I will revise it, means for the second reading. Then I would again give the mock test, means after second revision I would give the mock test. Okay, then again when after doing this whole mock test completion, I would start in March with again the revision of these all things. Okay. And then I will again attempt the tests of other coaching because I have already attempted certain tests. And then in the end, last 15 days before prelims, I would again revise them in a very very cursory manner. Or if I have certain notes, then I would go through that note. So in an all, I mean 3 or 4 revisions would happen from first reading to till the mains, till the prelims. Sorry.
So sir, with every iteration, you were also revising the previous mock test that you attempted?
No, I did not revise all the mock tests, but certainly the questions which I got wrong in those mocks, I would note them down in a separate notebook or a separate A4 sheet, and then I would revise that A4 sheet only, not the whole test.
Thanks a lot.
Okay. So I am ending this session now, so we can discuss these things on later on because I am also exhausted by now. So I am sorry
you,
I cannot take up other questions. So I will answer other queries on टेलीग्राम चैनल, यू जस्ट पोस्ट देम देयर. ओके ग्रेट.
यस थैंक यू सर.
ओके थैंक यू.
थैंक यू सर. हैप्पी दिवाली सर.
हैप्पी दिवाली.